highlights continue with the Brooklyn Nets and Toronto to take on the Raptors. Pascal Siakam, Terrence Davis, a little pregame handshake. And they're putting their franchise best 13-game start on the line with no Kyle Lowry and no Marc Gasol in this one. But doesn't seem to be a problem for Fred VanVleet. But Caris LeVert fires back on the other end. The Raptors, though, outscoring Brooklyn 33-18 in the second quarter.
That's tough. That's a big hole to dig yourself out of.
Look at this. The pass and the finish from Serge Ibaka to Matt Thomas for the reverse layup. This is another all-star move from Pascal.
That's crazy. And I know that we talk about this all the time, but I love the way that they step up by committee. It's not just one particular guy that's going to overwhelm you with astronomical numbers. They're doing it all collectively.
Although VanVleet did have some pretty astronomical numbers, 29 points, 6 assists in this one.
And the impressive thing about this game is that they had a tough game yesterday against Indiana. And had to travel back and play, you know, a second night of a back-to-back without Lowry, without Gasol, as you mentioned, and without Norman Powell, who had been playing well with him. And they had guys that were ready to step up and take advantage, like Terrence Davis.
Caris LeVert, though, stepping up and taking advantage without Kyrie Irving in the lineup, but just wouldn't be quite enough down the stretch. After Siakam would split a pair of free throws, sear the Nets with a chance to win, can't get it to go. Time expires. LeVert with a career-high 37 points in this one, 6 of 7 from behind the three-point line. But the Raptors go on to win it 119-118. Why won't you call him Spicy P?
Because I'm grown. Right. I'm not calling no grown man that. I call him Big P now. It could be Big P or something like that.
Why is Big P better than Spicy? You know what? No. You know what? No. We'll come back to this later. Here's Fred VanVleet. The reigning champion Raptors have now not lost a game since January 12th, a franchise-best 14 games in a row. No Kyle Lowry, even though he's in that picture, and no Marc Gasol in this one either. This team, one that is looking to continue to defy expectations for this season without Kawhi Leonard in the lineup.
Yeah, you mentioned the departure of the Finals MVP, Kawhi Leonard, and also the expectations. Like, you would think that they would immediately change, and all of a sudden they come back and they're like, look, we want to show people that we're a really good team. We're not a one-man band, and that's exactly what they're doing, and they're doing it by committee, like we touched on, and collectively they're defending extremely well.
You know, I think that, you know, last year they got a lot of practice playing without Kawhi when he was load managing. And what people forget is that they are the defending champions, that they do have championship DNA, that they have a lot of guys on this team that went through the wars to win that championship last year, and they are the definition of a team. That, you know, they it doesn't matter who it is. And like I said, three players, Gasol, Lowry, their starting point guard, their starting center, and Norman Powell, who have been playing well for them, and then they just step up with VanVleet tonight. They step up with Terrence Davis, and everybody gives contributions. They took care of the ball. You know, they only had 7 turnovers, and so all the little things that they do. And then on top of that, you got to give Nick Nurse a lot of credit as well, because in the games that they play, when they play other teams that have had superstars, they've been able to take them out of their games with different defensive schemes. All season long, they've been consistent in doing that. And now you look up and they're second in the East.
Yeah.
You know, that's saying a lot. And I think that they like cruising there under the radar and ready in position and peaking at the right time.
You mentioned that Terrence Davis saw an opportunity and stepped up. Caron, with what he's doing, especially from behind the arc, what is he doing for this Raptors offense?
Look, he's making shots, you know, specifically, you know, knocking down 5 of 8 from 3 tonight. Look, you're making yourself available, and sometimes it's a clear case of this KYP. Know your personnel. This is a clear case of the Brooklyn Nets not knowing their personnel, knowing that he's able to knock down shots on the perimeter, and this, they're doing a remarkable job at finding them. You see a pick and roll situation, he's going to, you know, stay on the perimeter, continue to move. You said this is all about watching the Splash Brothers and, you know, seeing what they've done over the last couple of years and the success that they had, and now teams are really starting to copy. You have to stay ready. You see 3 at the line, at the free throw line, all across, straight across, and you're going to give that much airspace to a shooter that's ready to shoot and make that opportunity happen, let it fly.
Only his second career start, 20-plus in each.
And you know what? And what I love about him is he plays with a chip on his shoulder every single night. So he brings toughness to this team. You know, Kyle Lowry is their tough guy, even though he's one of the smaller guys on their team. But he brings that same kind of edge every night when he plays. And for a young player who I believe went undrafted, having this opportunity, he plays the game and understands that, you know, that you keep moving offensively, you don't stop. His ability to relocate and keep moving, and he takes what the defense gives him. He doesn't try to force anything, and that's rare to see from a young player with the little amount of experience that he has.
Well, let's stay in the Eastern Conference after the break, then, shall we? Highlights. The reigning